Your word, O Lord God, is all I hold on to.
To empower ourselves and also to be able to spread the message of the kingdom. And as we know that, the Lord will continue to manifest himself in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. So we need all your support, including brethren that are away and those that are not here. We need all the total support. So apart from this program, we shall be organizing workshops, empowerment workshops, workshops on health, workshops on credits, you know, to see, because we face a lot of challenges in America. And we face a lot of challenges, and there's a need. Sometimes we don't have information. And one of the things we need basically is to find ways to source information. So we shall be holding a series of workshops on how we can empower ourselves financially, physically, and spiritually, so that we shall continue to be the head of our household and not the tail, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So we count for your support, and as I said, we also count for the support of our pastors. So I'm going to stop for now, and one of our members come, we should also have more opportunities to say some few things. Thank you, brother.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Time for praise and worship. Amen.
Amen.
Are we ready to praise the Lord? God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Thank you.
honor to be here. When they said we should be here, I'm like, what am I going here to do? When the arrows are here, like Pastor Sam is there and all that. And why? And I said I have to be here in obedience, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Without wasting much time, when this meeting is for the men of valor, right?
Yes.
And I found that I have to look at what is valor, what's the meaning of valor? And in my own understanding, because we have to go with understanding in everything we do, amen?
Yes.
So we'll be able to get to the end, bearing in mind what we are looking for, where we're going for, what we want, and we gather the tools to fulfill. Amen? If we don't understand where we are going, who we are, and how we are going to go about it, we'll not be able to fulfill. Am I right? The book of Psalm 32 verse 8 said, the Lord said, I will redirect you. Amen?
Amen.
I'll teach you the way you go, and I will guide you. So if we have those tools in our hands, we look up to Him anytime we get confused. Amen? And when I was looking for the meaning of valor, it took me to my own dictionary. I don't know what that's about. It says, it's great courage in the face of danger. Amen. The valor means great courage in the face of danger. And I want us to know when we go have that courage that only comes from God. That means we have to be connected with God 24 hours. Amen. Because the darkness also is fighting, amen? It's not just we, it's not just you as men of valor. What I remember is a battle, it's a war front. And the war front, we are there, the enemies are also there, amen? And they're also equipped in their own ways, but we have a greater power, greater glory, greater promise in Jesus' name. And I'll think, before we say a few prayers, I don't want to waste much time, we go to open the book of the Bible, the book of Judges, verse 6, chapter 6. We go straight to verse 12, please, so we can say a few prayers. We need to pray. Chapter 6, verse 10, 12, quickly, so that we'll just take about 10 minutes to go. If somebody will read very loud, an evangelist voice, as we read it, you try to see yourself inside this word of God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Somebody read 10, somebody 11, 12 quickly.
And I said unto you,
yes,
I am the Lord.
Yes.
Your God.
The Lord is saying that to you right now. Not to Gideon anymore. Amen?
Amen.
Put yourself in the word of God. Go ahead, brother.
Fear not the gods of these Amorites.
Oh, yes.
In whose land you dwell.
Yes.
But ye have not obeyed my words.
Mm-hmm.
And there came an angel of the Lord. And Samuel and Oak, which was Ophrah, that pertained unto Joash the Abarites, his son Gideon threshed wheat by the wild breast to hide me from the Midianites.
Say, I shall not hide.
I shall not hide.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
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 And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him and said unto him, the Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor.
Yes. And what did he say? Go ahead, somebody.
And Gideon said unto him, O my Lord, if the Lord be with us, when is all this befallen us? And where be all these miracles which our fathers told us of, saying, did not the Lord bring us from Egypt? But now the Lord hath forsaken us, and delivered us from the hands of the Midianites. Shall I continue?
Yes, quickly, because the prayer points come from there.
And the Lord looked upon him and said, go this thy might. Thou shalt save Israel from the hand of the Midianites, and have I not sent thee? And he said unto him, O my Lord, wherewith shall I save Israel? Behold, my family is poor in Manasseh, and I am the least in my father's house. And the Lord said unto him, surely I will be with thee, and thou shalt smite the Midianites as one man. And he said unto him, if now I have found grace in thy sight, then show me a sign that thou talkest with me. Depart not hence, I pray thee, until I come unto thee and bring forth my presence. and set it before thee. And he said, I will tarry until thou come again. And Gideon went in and made ready a kid and 11 cakes of an ephah of flour. The flesh he put in the basket, and he put in the broth in the pot, and brought it out unto him under the yoke, and presented it. And the angel of the Lord said unto him, take the flesh and the 11 cakes, and lay upon them this rock, and pour out the broth. And he did so. Then the angel of the Lord put forth the end of the staff that was in his hand, and touched the flesh and the 11 cakes, and there rose up fire out of the rock, and consumed the flesh and the 11 cakes. And then the angel of the Lord departed out of his sight.
Keep going.
And when Gideon perceived that he was an angel of the Lord, Gideon said, alas, O Lord God, for because I have seen an angel of the Lord face to face. And the Lord said unto him, peace be unto thee, fear not, thou shalt not die. Then Gideon built an altar there unto the Lord and called it Jehovah Shalom. And this day it is yet upright of thee, Abinazarites. And it came to pass the same night that the Lord said unto him, take thy father's young bullock, even the second bullock of the 7 years old, and throw down the altar of Baal that thy father hath, and cut down the grove that is named by it. And build an altar of the Lord that God upon the top of rock, in the other place, and take the second bullock, and offer a whole sacrifice to the wood of roof which thou shalt cut down. Then Gideon took 10 men of his servants, and did as the Lord had said unto him. And so it was, because he feared his father's household, and men of the city, that he could not do it by day, that he did it by night. And when the men of the city arose early in the morning, behold, the altar of Baal was cast down, and the roof was cut down that was by it. And the second blow was offered upon the altar that was built. And he said unto another, who had done this thing? And when they inquired and asked, they said, Gideon, the son of Joash, had done this thing. Then the men of the city said unto Joash, bring out thy son, that he may die, because he has cut down the altar of Baal, because he had cut down the grove that was by it. And Joash said unto all that was stood by this again, will ye plead for Baal? Will ye save him? That he may plead for him, let him be put to death by his yet one. If I be a God, let him plead for himself, because one has cast down his altar.
Amen.
Yeah.
Can you find yourself here? In this calling, you need a lot of sacrifice. You need to do a lot of sacrifice. We need a lot of sacrifice to attain to our fulfillment, to our calling. Because the Word of God said, we are in the world, but we are not of the world. A lot of sacrifice in our flesh, a lot of sacrifice to know the Word of God, a lot of sacrifice to walk with the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
It needs a lot of denials. It needs a lot of strength. And with that, we cannot be a wimp. We cannot have the power of fear. Gideon was in captivity, in bondage. And all that was looking in front of him, what faces him in that bondage, that captivity. And that swallowed the seed of God in him. And he starts seeing himself as a wimp, as a failure. Amen. So, and that brings all the two prayer points I came here with. Amen. So that will not waste my your time. Only when a stronger man comes, he will will bind him and loosen the cords. Amen?
Amen.
So we're going to call to the greater power. Amen?
Amen.
Say, oh, greater power, greater glory. Overshadow me. Empower me. Don't do conquest for you. Don't do exploits for you. In the name of Jesus. Oh, greater power, greater glory. Overshadow me. Empower me. Don't do exploits for you. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Pray that prayer.
Amen.
Amen.
Quickly, if you don't notice him, you can open your Bible to Psalm 25. Have limited time. Psalm 25, and sing verses 1 and 2 with me. Are we there? Unto thee, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. O my God, I trust in thee. Let me not be ashamed. Let not my enemies triumph over me. If you know it, please sing it with me. Either sitting down or standing up. Let's have a seat, brethren. We're going to pray that prayer point again. In the meantime, in the few minutes I have, this short word of exhortation, I call it Moment of Truth. Moment of Truth. That is the time when we men should be truthful to ourselves, should be honest with ourselves. In that Psalm 25 that we sang, what are we doing with God? We are asking, right? So we want to receive. And oftentimes too, when we open our Bible, what are we doing? We are asking, we are receiving. Don't get me wrong, there's nothing wrong with that. In the book of Ezekiel, chapter 36, verse 26, the Lord God himself says, a new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you. And I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you a heart of flesh. Verse 27a said, and I will put my spirit within you, and cause you to walk in my statutes, and ye shall keep my judgments, and do them. So God is promising what he's going to give. But then, towards the end of verse 57, he also gave a challenge. What you and I as men must what? Must do. We must keep his judgments, his statutes, his righteousness, and so on. But here is the truth, brethren. Men, we are lacking our responsibility. I don't care whether you are just ordinary member. I don't want to know whether you are just a man, whether you are a pastor. And that is why the situation in the society has become what it is. A while ago, a man went to a pastor and quote unquote reported his wife. This man, this woman, since he went to school, and since he became a nurse, she is not listening to me, she this and that. Okay, is that what? Is it? He said yes. So, if care is not taken, I'm going to stop her from coming to this church. Pastor was calm. Eventually invited the two of them. And the man started blaring up again, blah, 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 blah. Hey, when he put food on the table, he will expect me to go and take the water to wash my hand by myself. In America. He went on and on and on and on. Very respectful woman. Original Maguli, very respectful. After the man, blah, 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 then the pastor said, madam, say something now. She just didn't want to say it. But prodding her after a while, she said, sir, I don't want to say this, but I have to say it. I am tired of my husband telling the debtors, telling the creditors, telling the landlord that, my wife is not at home. That is a loaded statement. Everything, my wife is home come. My wife is not at home. When children come from school and ask for this, wait for your mother. And when she went up on and on like that, power has changed hands. Not by witchcraft means, but by whatever power. Long story short, the woman eventually left the church. Not because she didn't want, not because she wanted to leave. But the man said, enough is enough. The reason why you are not giving enough money in the house is because you contribute to money in that church you are going. You're contributing to your so-called tithe. And the man was asked, sir, do you also contribute to the house? Pastor, you have no right to ask me that. I brought this woman to this country. Is that what should be the answer? I don't want you to discuss and say what has come upon men. Let's not deceive ourselves. There are so many homes like that today in America. Men have voluntarily surrendered their power. And we expect the blessing of God to still be coming upon us. There's nothing wrong in empowering our wives, the women. But at the same time, brethren, also empower yourself. But I look at it again from the spiritual aspect. Why is men like, why is it becoming adapted, especially in this society? When we are back home in Africa, in the Caribbean, wherever we come from, it is not like that. But when we get here, something happens. The moment of truth is that men, we have gone far from God, and we need to return. There is a hymn I requested. I don't know whether it is possible. It is now,
Yes, sir.
Oh, it is now him. It says, I've wandered far away. You can play the lyric, just press the small button by the side of it. If you get it from hymnal.net. I've wandered far away from God, now I'm coming home. The path of sin too long I've trod, Lord, I'm coming home. That should be what we men should be singing. Don't get me wrong, we are trying. We are trying. I've seen men, many of them is coming. They train their wives, but afterward, the wife left. I should know. For those of you who know why I say that. Because when men are training the wives up, they are not training themselves up. They are comfortable with $10 per hour. And the woman comes out of the school of nursing. You encourage her to go for the other ones. There is nothing wrong in that. But I'm saying, as you are lifting them up, for God's sake, lift yourself too up. Because it is natural in them to expect that you be the leader. So if she is contributing $1,000 and you are contributing 1,000 cents, listen, there will be a problem. It doesn't matter whether you are the one that trained her. It's a common thing and it's still going. It's good, empower them. Let's lift them up. But men often make that mistake of not dragging our own selves to along. Again, I say, I should know. Let's learn from the mistake of other people. So if you are a man and you are here today, learn from there. And then we need to return to God. And that's why we come for that song. Let it play, brethren. We will sing it, and then we'll pray that prayer one more time. But if we can forget everything that I've said here today, I'm saying that it's the moment of truth. Let us start praying. When we need to return to God. I've wandered far away from God.